I really hope that you enjoyed our class thus far. And we tried to go into some things Sunday to in hopes that the younger ones in the saints might come to our understanding when we're speaking. Let me explain in part, to try to move along kind of time. It's great when you can read the Bible that was written by men that were inspired of Yahweh, the same one that dwells in you, and understand it.
Yes, sir.
When you do understand what is written, then you become conscious that the same one that dealt with those whom you're reading after is the same one that's dealing with you.
Yes.
Because you can read anything as far as reading and not understand what it is you're reading.
That's true.
Or the circumstances around it.
Yeah.
That is one thing we're brought up that The schools don't seem to understand, nor do they want to hear, that where the apostles talked about Yahshua so much, it was because that many people didn't know who Yahshua was.
All right.
It was revealed to them on the day of Pentecost All who right. this Yahshua was. In fact, that is Peter's opening statement on the day of Pentecost. Let the whole house of Israel know.
Yes.
That man whom you ignorantly crucified was Yahweh or Elohim from heaven.
That's right.
And that's who that was.
Mm.
So, in the apostolic days, or the days of the apostles, they suffered much persecution. And a lot of the epistles or letters that you have written by Saul were written from prison. You see, every time they opened their mouth, their freedom was taken away from them, and they were cast into prison.
Right.
And this incident here where they brought forth James, the Peter, James, and John that traveled together, the same ones that Yahweh took up from the mountain here.
Yes, sir.
And they were going to slay John and Peter, but for fear of the Jews, because the Passover was near, Yahweh working a purpose.
Right.
They didn't slay those two. You understand?
Yeah.
And the cardinal point here is that understanding why James was slain, you follow?
Yes. Yeah. Oh,
did he suffer pain?
Oh, yeah.
In other words, the circumstances around.
That's right.
So I'm saying they were beheaded and in other words, put to death for their faith in Yahweh. Dr. Horn, not too many months ago, said that the very self-same thing that you believe and teach here now is the self-same thing they were crucified or killed for.
That's right.
So it behooves us, I said all that to say this, it behooves us to look back, you see, and see the persecution that many had preserving this gospel and reserving it to us, you see,
yes,
that we be as diligent in not only in coming to class, but in learning and putting on that which you the thing taught you.
That's right.
You see?
That's
you,
right.
There's one thing that you should understand. You can't kid Yahweh.
That's right.
You can't say that I really want to know and you don't. And you serve him haphazardly and go get anywhere.
All right.
That's words of encouragement to you. It's not chastisement, but nevertheless a fact. The prophet said, man's whole duty.
Right.
Okay. Whole duty means something total of
it. Yes, sir.
But to worship, honor, and glorify Yah. And Paul, that's where Paul got the statement that, therefore, glorify Yahweh in your body, in your spirit, which is his.
That's right.
And Messiah had the same testimony. He said, when he was about to be crucified, he said, Father, I have glorified thy name on earth.
That's right.
And you understand?
That's
right.
He
was ready to go on and take the body off, which is to say, go on back home.
All right.
Now, we have preserved this gospel. I'm talking about the true one. They've preserved it. That those whom Yahweh had foreordained to come in to the same body, the same understanding.
Yes.
We've suffered too.
Yes, sir.
And I've told you something of mine. I don't know if we're going into that. But I'm saying that everywhere I go, I'm looking at it. There's a devil, and I'm this, and I'm that.
Uh-huh.
You see? And just naturally speaking, everybody desires to be liked.
That's right.
To love, to be loved. You see what I mean? I'm not a, just my general makeup as a, just a human being. I'm not a vengeful, spiteful person. One that you can't get along with. And one that's always changing his mind. And one time I'm nice, another time I'm something else.
Right.
So I just don't have that in me. But nevertheless, I'm saying, so it has this repercussions in that I recognize now and have for many years what you're bucking. You see, it's not IDMR, it's not any teachers that's standing before you. It's Yahweh himself that you are again.
That's right.
And that goes for anybody that knows.
That's right.
Now, I had to say it that way, because he's the one that don't know, he's Yahweh, but he don't know it yet.
That's right.
And that's why he's continually raising up against one another. Mm. So, I'm saying it behooves us to, some of the things that I want to do for you, okay, the new ones is getting back now. When we say, this one was stoned to death, this is one of the arguments I had with the L.A. class. He told me that I don't use the pattern. I'm speaking rather forcefully to get my voice to come out. That I didn't use the pattern. And these are people that have been in school for 10, 12, 15 years or longer. Now, that any time you talk about death, you ought to know where to put it.
That's right.
You see?
Oh,
if you talk about an appearance of Yahweh, you ought to know where to put it.
That's right.
Now, these are people that are supposed to know by the pattern the things that are contained in the scriptures and whether it is so or not.
That's right.
You understand that?
Yes.
So I'm saying, I recognize that many of you here, we've attempted to try to go back and to lay down and come down through this pattern plate by plate. But it's a hard thing to do in that the reality is not there.
All right.
It's just not there. These are types and shadows. And we're so anxious for you to learn the reality of what you're looking at. And what you're really looking at is an image likened unto Yahweh that's in you.
Go ahead.
No, you have to see yourself in what we're teaching.
Right.
See? That's why Paul said, let every man examine himself.
Right.
Well, examine himself by what? By the things that's contained in the scripture.
Oh,
you follow me? You're Yahweh's epistle.
That's right. That's right.
You see? These are the books that cannot be destroyed.
That's right.
You see?
Mm. That's right.
But you can't mix in this book some academic training and pitch it against this understanding.
That's right.
If, like I said, that in Ohio, that John the Baptist, it was born of the Immaculate Conception.
Come on.
Now they want to go in a damn dictionary and try to refute what I said about John the Baptist's birth. You see? Well, I'm looking right at the pattern to tell you.
Yes.
You see?
Yes, sir.
And we did that Sunday.
That's right.
You see, now you that were here were not here. I'm talking about this profess to be students or members or part of the Bible. See, I think it's your duty to be.
That's right.
You see? You never know what Yahweh puts in a vessel, having you in mind.
That's right.
You see? And that's when it's at its peak.
Alright.
You see, now, tonight, somebody wanted to speak in Spanish. It didn't flow.
Right. Right.
You see? I'm not saying it wasn't any good, but it didn't. In other words, we're going to have to learn how to time ourselves and understand how the purpose of Yahweh is unfolding, that when we step into position, everything we do is fruitful.
That's right.
So if we do it contrary, it's a work, it's a job.
That's good.
See, if everybody came to class with a desire to understand, the speaker that stood before you would pick that up and preach.
That's right.
See, but when you're asleep, this and that, debating, and this and that, everybody looking off and seeing others snapping gums, others worry about what some rock star doing and where I could be and everything. It's too hot here. Then that's what you got going on. Now Yahweh don't deal in no confused state of existence at no time.
That's right.
I'm saying this, if you say you want to see as other than things.
Right. That's what we say.
You know, I'm thinking about love and ugly all the time.
That's right.
It's your affection. If you be risen with Messiah, set your affection. So that means you know that Yahweh has assembled us together on Wednesday and Friday and Sunday.
Right.
So that means you got Monday and Tuesday.
That's right.
All day Wednesday to start training these kids.
That's right.
You see? So you can't let them run wild.
Right.
Monday, Tuesday, and expect all of a sudden.
No.
They don't know about time.
No.
To sit still for 2.5 hours Wednesday night. If something's going to plague you from now on.
That's right.
Right.
And all it is, if you notice, and I'm not calling your children devil.
Come on.
I'm telling you, they Yahweh too.
That's right.
See? You understand? But they'll plague you where, when you want to know, they got you outside.
That's right.
That's right.
And I've seen kids, when you get up to take them out, they're grinning as you take them out.
That's right.
That's right.
If I said your child was a devil, you'd be offended, you probably wouldn't come out.
That's right.
But recognize, y'all, the devil don't care nothing about who he operates.
That's right.
That is right.
Whatever it is.
That's right.
Anything to distract you, he'll do.
That's right.
We were warned this way by the founder. He said, you know, you be in class all the time, you sitting there and the teacher speaking, and somebody comes and you turn around and see who comes. You're distracted.
That's right.
And something that might put a complete thought together is that you turn around and see who it is. When you turn around, that person at that time is in your mind and your heart.
Right.
The thought that is being portrayed is not there.
That's right.
That's true.
You see? So we can easily be distracted. You see? So, and thus it becomes a laborious job and someone that is trying to get you, as I told you, I want you to come to work. You recognize Yahweh.
That's good.
Well, now, and it's according to the purpose. Then somebody says, well, that's just something you want. No, it's written that after those days, you follow me, you write his laws in your heart and your mind,
right.
And you wouldn't have to ask one another.
That's right.
No, you Yahweh. Because it all is only from the least to the greatest.
That's right.
So you give some kind of, I don't want to say respect or, in other words, encourage those that's willing to teach you by you being here.
Right.
You follow?
Right.
Now, if that offends you, I'm just sorry. You know, it's the truth.
Yes, right. Sir.
You really don't know what it is you're playing with.
Mm.
You follow me? And that's what I want you to come to. When you can see it for yourself,
yes,
and know that there's nothing in the world no more important than assembling yourselves unto the other.
That's right.
And Paul said, even if you see the day approach,
come on.
You see?
That's right.
Well, let me quote it. Forsake not to assemble yourselves together as a man is of some. And even more so.
Oh, that's right.
As you see the day approach.
All right.
You see?
That's right.
That's good. Now, that's words of encouragement from one that was caught up in the third heaven.
That's right.
And it'll stick to this day.
That's right.
So, I mean, it cannot be where you come and learn for a couple of hours, you understand? And it don't mean nothing. It doesn't influence you.
Come on.
It doesn't, you understand?
Yes,
it cause you to, in other words, it makes a complete change.
That's right.
You see, I ran out of words trying to explain those kinds of things.
Right.
I tried every stupid parable I knew to use and divine psychology that I knew to use. The problem. And the thing of it is, if you haven't caught on now, you deserve to live.
All right.
I don't mean the new ones. I'm talking about those have been, I'll say this, those have been in classes here almost ever since this class started. Now that's going on 7 years.
Yeah.
And 7 years in anybody's book, you know, some kind of perfection.
Oh, yeah,
that means you got something perfect.
Everything.
If it ain't nothing, but I'm going to class. If it took you, then nothing's going to stop me. I got that learned.
That's right.
But this pushing and pulling, you see, you're going to have to recognize this gospel, which is you.
That's right.
Must go forward. We have these crazies in earthen vessels.
Oh, yeah.
You see what I mean?
without you. And I told you about these things. That's why I told the Hebrews, said, let your light so shine.
That's what he said.
You see? Yes. Now, I wasn't talking about no candlelight. You know, somebody said, well, I know what to do. I take a 40 watt bulb out and put a 100 watt in it. Let my light shine. We ain't talking about that.
Yes, sir.
See, that illumination in you.
Yes, sir.
That soul shines. That other men, what other men? The Gentiles.
Oh,
might
yeah.
see your good work
oh, yeah,
and glorify
yeah.
your Father with
yeah.
you.
All right.
Mm-hmm. And you don't have time to argue with every Tom, Dick, and Harry that wants to fight you about this gospel.
That's
the hell
right.
with them.
That's right.
That's right.
All right.
That's what I just told y'all. They are with the rest of the school. Damn them.
All right.
Anybody else that don't want to serve y'all?
That's right.
That's right. He just tugging and pushing and tugging and pushing and pushing. You know that? You can't take the leg.
No.
And I'm telling you now, I ain't going.
All right.
I'm telling you, I ain't going.
All right.
I said it like Yahshua said. Yahshua the Messiah said, for me and my household,
all right.
you do what you want. But I'm going to serve Yahweh.
All right.
And I want that same conviction within you. See, where you're not bogged down with the things of the world. Sometimes just relax and let Yahweh move the hearts. And you sit and just think.
Yes.
And move the minds and hearts of men.
Yes.
Move obstacles out of your way.
All right.
There ain't no sense in you being bogged down about a damn thing.
All right.
If you want to know about the problem, let me tell you about something. I'll tell you about the problem. I live on a time bomb.
Uh-uh.
You know what I mean? And I'm trying to keep that sucker diffused every day. You know what I mean? By that I mean knowing when the end shall be.
Oh, yeah.
And somebody said, no man knows. That's right. Don't no man know.
All right.
No man don't know.
Kevin. That's right.
Don't talk to me like that. And you, I tell you something else. You can't push me into telling you.
That's right.
You know, to prove that to you. What you're going to have to do is that is going to have to be revealed.
All right.
And you wouldn't recognize. I told you the time, the date, and everything else over and over again, but you're chewing gum, more interested in this, and that, and styles going on today, and this, that, and the other. You know what I mean? And I'm hungry, and what am I going to do tomorrow, and how am I going to get this done? You know
what I mean?
That's it, everybody.
One way or another.
That's right.
That's the way we're built. You got to learn to overcome it.
That's right.
See, those are the obstacles in the world that you have in this thing, you see, that are surrounded with demonic fear and warring against you. You got to learn how to put them in the place.
That's right. I heard that.
You understand that?
Go ahead.
Now, what you got here tonight, I'll just deal with that. Well, let me say this. That all of the scriptures, Paul put it this way to his son in the same Timothy. He said, all scripture that is given.
Mm-hmm.
Now that qualifies it right there. Mm-hmm. All scripture that is given.
Come on.
Now there's a whole lot of scripture not given.
Mm-hmm.
You see? Mm-hmm. Of Yahweh. Mm-hmm. But all that is given of Yahweh.
All right.
You see? Yeah. So, mm-hmm. Is what?
It's given by the inspiration of
y'all. It's given by the inspiration of y'all.
Go ahead.
Would you recognize that you're the inspiration of y'all?
Yeah.
I just got through telling you.
Yeah.
When you come with a desire to know,
yeah.
that it is you, Yahweh in you, inspires Yahweh in the speaker.
That's right.
You follow me? It's the same element here.
That's right.
You follow me? To preach. You understand? Know
yeah.
And that glory in you is glorifying me.
That's right.
And the glory in me is glorifying
that's
you.
That's right. That's how it works.
You see? Everybody told me from Sunday they really enjoyed class Sunday.
Yeah.
You see? And what I did, I just laid aside, same thing I'm just laid aside the disappointment I felt.
Yeah.
And caught you in him. In other words, I kept it in mind not to let you down because
right.
you were here.
Right.
But God is something else.
Yeah.
So I warmed with that in myself and freed myself from it and went on and talked.
All right.
And it's the first time I turned loose like that in a long time.
Yeah.
Because what I'm saying in that is I'm forever dealing with things that don't matter then when you get through with it.
Right.
It's like I told you about, who was Clark Gable's first wife and how many kids did you have? When you get through with it, ain't done no bit of good.
That's right.
They don't add any trouble, right? You don't take it away. You just don't know nothing.
That's right.
And most of the time, the people you're talking about is already dead.
Right.
But anyhow.
Hello. This pattern was given to Moses from South Mount Sinai. And it was a pattern, Hebrews 8 5, I just quote. It's a pattern of heavenly things.
Right.
You got it? I'm talking about this pattern here. This is a pattern. Listen, it's a pattern of heavenly things.
Yes, sir.
It is not the heavenly thing itself.
All right.
If the suit you got on that fits you, it's a pattern of your body.
Right.
But it's not your body.
All right.
And see, so if you wear a size 40, then that's a pattern of a heavenly thing. Right.
Yeah.
You're the one that's created in the likeness and image. You know what I'm saying? And it's more perfect. Then the suit you gotta go.
That's
you
right.
Can't see damn right go. You find seams and threads.
That's right.
And then some of it, when you look at the body, there is no seam.
That's right.
No threads. It's put together in a unit. You understand?
Gone, man.
Come? Just like you talk about the sun and the evening and the morning just blending. You can't tell where nighttime starts, where day. Evening, is that begin? And you look at your hand, you can't tell where it starts with one color. You see,
that's right.
Well, it just blends. You know?
That's
right.
Oh, boy.
You understand? Yeah. But listen, there is a line of demarcation.
All right.
And it takes you being spiritual to see it in the earth.
Yes.
That's the wind to step in, wind to move.
All right.
You follow?
Yeah. Come on.
So this pattern was given to Moses. As a pattern of heavenly things. Now this is the heavenly thing that Paul is talking about.
Right.
And that Elohim, is it which is hard for me to get the school done, Elohim himself transformed into that.
That's right.
You see?
Right. That's right.
But then this was a pattern of this.
That's right.
That's right.
It's not vice versa.
That's right.
You follow? And the mere fact that he transformed into it, you understand? Fully furnished,
these
all those attributes came with.
That's right.
And you can't stop nowhere along the line.
That's right.
You see, because that's his supernal nature and disposition.
That's
so,
right.
Anything he creates, he becomes that himself.
Yes.
You see, that's how John could say, the Apostle John could say, without him, there wasn't nothing made that was made.
That's right.
Without him, what? Without him transforming into it.
Right.
You see? Now, can't you see if the gospel is preaching, it transforms you from an earthly state to a heavenly state?
That's right.
If I put the type and shadow in there correctly.
Exactly.
Going back to them saying that they preached gospel because nobody knew who he was.
All right.
And going through, and talk about knowing circumstances around. Listen, I didn't been there.
All right. Come on, man. Come on.
This is that I'm writing. I have to recall what Yahweh showed me about Abraham.
You can tell it when you read it.
That's right.
You were bad.
I've got it from start to finish.
That's right.
I'm not going to be a particular. Somebody, I don't really give a damn.
That's right. Yes,
as you look at me, am not the one declared to know.
That's right.
That was foreordained in heaven.
That's right.
And that's the thing I'm going to hold on to.
All right.
And then I'm not going to lose eternal life on account of my own foolishness. Say nothing about yours.
Go ahead.
Because if I had my way as a man, I'd throw in the towel a long time ago.
Jesus.
And tried to several times.
Yeah. That's true.
And the towel was thrown back at me.
All right.
One time the pastor said, if you can't do what the school wants you to do, and these officers on school, turn your lights in. I said, zip, go, shoot, right on into the office. I said, fine. Yeah, because I wasn't going to conform to nothing they were talking about. And it wasn't that I'm contentious, and, you know what I mean, and evil. What they were talking about wasn't worth a damn.
Go ahead.
That's what like all of big shots sit on the front.
Right.
And us peons, you ever pull me up on something, I ain't going along with that. I was taught there's no big eyes, no use in the kingdom.
Go ahead. Right.
And I ain't going to be no part of it.
All right.
Since I turned my life to me. Those words came from the fountain, I obeyed it.
Go ahead.
So I was always out one Sunday, and I felt this was free.
that shot down.
Yeah? I felt good. I already bothered me. He told me, he said, Dr. Groves told me you turned your lights in. I said, yes, sir, I sure did. I think you ought to go back down there and get them. I said, what?
Oh, boy.
I said, but you said if we couldn't conform,
yeah.
I said, I'm not going to conform to that. He said, well, that ain't nothing but a bunch of junk. Go get your license.
All right, man.
Well, I don't beat. I went to have to head.
Yes, sir.
He told me, come down. Now, I know when you're doing it, that the lighting ain't working.
Right.
He knew it. Too, you see?
But I'm saying, I tried throwing some. I am for right.
That's right.
That's right. Now, a lot of people think that I'm not a loving person a lot of times. I'm not. I don't have no feeling, you know what I mean? I'm without this.
No, I just refuse to promote you in your ego. Whoever you are, you know what I mean? You can act stupid all you want to, but I'm not involved.
All right.
All right,
now, I had my sermon being stupid.
Go ahead, man.
And I found out this, it don't do nothing. The more stupid you act and things you got to go through, it's just more you got to turn around and clean up sooner or later.
That's right.
You know, I mean, you let your house go dirty all year long, but sooner or later you got to clean it. Because it'll get to the point where you can't say
it. That's right. That's
good. That's if you ain't got any decency at all. But anyhow,
the pattern dictates.
This is the pattern of heavenly thing. Now, my wife, it doesn't make any difference. Now, this one, if we wanted the new one to understand and use it, haven't quite learned that you have to find this principle of this pattern, listen now, with this operating in it. You see? Since he transformed into it. See, you have to find this principle manifested in this.
All right.
Then it becomes a pattern of heaven. And that's what you are while you walk around in this. You are that archetype pattern.
Yes.
Walking in earth.
That's right.
That's right.
Now, if you're not that, then the gospel preached to you is another fact.
That's right.
You know, think of it. I don't get no, but think of it. Here's apostles. They're under military rule or whatever you want to call it, governmental rule, just like you are now.
That's right.
And they brought forth James, I'm repeating, and slew him. And they knew it. James and John knew it. I mean, Peter and John knew it. You know?
Yes, they knew it.
And they brought Peter forth. And Paul said, well, we can't get, but we're going to scold
him. Uh-huh.
And we're going to turn you loose.
Oh, check that.
And threaten him, you see.
Check
and said, you go out here and don't be preaching in that name no more.
Win.
And Peter looked at him. You know that something got to take place.
That's right.
That's right.
You tell us whether it's to fight us to obey man or y'all.
That's right.
Now, you don't walk up nobody. Somebody got tired of that's put you to death on the cross. And talk like that.
That's right.
That's the kind of conversion I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Now nobody come up against you.
No.
That's right.
You follow? You're more or less free to worship Yahweh.
Yeah.
You understand?
Yes.
Close down the business, close down everything. Close down everything, Carter.
That's right.
Put a padlock on you get back.
Wow. That's right.
Come on, serve Yahweh.
Right.
And I'll tell you something else, that'll be the thing that'll protect your other thing while you're absent from it.
That's right.
That is right.
That's the truth.
He can
hold anything he wants to hold.
That's true.
But it requires complete obedience.
Yes, sir. All right.
And you know,
yes.
Eating ain't such a bad job. Eating is not such a bad job.
No.
When you start see drinking water, ain't such a bad job.
No.
When you sleepy, going to sleep ain't such a bad job.
Come on.
But do you know that's obedience?
That's right. It sure is.
When your body says thirsty, You go against the grain. You don't go, well, man, I'm not ready for it. Oh, you got to argue with you. You could die of thirst arguing. You know what I'm saying? A lot of things you call, you do obediently with no problem.
Yeah.
It, you think it and carry it out now.
Come on, dude.
And it's not the cares of this life. You follow me? When you understand, you're going to thirst because it's in your inner man that is yet thirsting after righteousness.
Yes.
You see? And just like you don't fight getting a drink of water, neither should you fight coming and learning.
All right.
You see? Because it's the only thing that's going to quench the fiery darts of a satanic spirit born again.
That's right.
That's right. I'm
going to help. You're doing it.
I got all kinds of problems. I got some problems I ain't never told you. You follow?
Yes, sir.
But I don't let them bother me. I'm just telling you, no. I'll deal with it.
Mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
But I don't get upset when it affects my inner man, but so never. Because
right.
I know it belongs in file 13.
All right.
File 13 is a garbage can of trash can. So, by getting back, now this is the pattern. Now, see this overshadowing here?
Yes.
The two angels.
Yes.
Now you see other charts, not charts, but biblical pictures of these angels. And you see them kneeling.
Yes.
And their wings not touching, or no wings. You follow?
Yeah.
Now the question is that correct? This is in the Bible, right?
Sure is, man.
You follow? Now, when you look, since this is a pattern of heavenly things, then, and you are that's made up like this, then does the right and left hemisphere of the brain touch?
Yes.
Then these have to touch?
Yeah. That's all right. Go ahead.
They have to touch. They're joined together.
Yes.
You follow? Mm. So if you see a picture of the Ark of the Covenant, you see, now these angels were standing,
yes,
you see, in the ways of Yahweh, not kneeling.
All right.
See, these are the angels that withstood.
All right.
Satan and his hosts in heaven, so they have to be standing.
Yes.
All right.
You follow? What I'm trying to do is let you know that the secrets that's in men's minds and hearts everywhere, you see, and give you the answer to be able to answer them.
All right.
You follow?
All right.
And though I know it's not possible for me to tell you as a man all that someone else could ask you, but if I give you the key to it,
yes,
then while they're yet asking,
yes,
Yahweh will give you the answer within.
Very good.
You see? And there will be no break in the continuity.
All right.
I want you to get to that stage.
Yes.
Well, if you're going to stumble, you're going to fall, you're acquainted, you see, then you can't get anywhere. Now, again, trying to get to this pattern. This pattern here, now, let me just say it this way. It's about Messiah. That's all anything is about. It's not just about a single manifestation.
Come on.
It
man.
Is Yahweh in his sum total.
Yes.
You follow?
Oh boy.
Which means it is dealing with the Father, the Word, and the Holy Spirit,
that's
and
right.
These three ones. It's not dealing with just Yahshua.
That's right. Well
see,
said.
Now, I don't know what I said, but I want to make sure. When they talk about there is no other name given whereby that a man can be saved, saving the name of Yahshua. What the circumstances around that was and is to this day, that they had God everywhere.
All right.
That's right.
You follow me?
That's right.
Paul uses that description this,
right.
Description there.
Right.
And then they had one just.
Martin Hill.
Right. Just in case they missed one.
Right.
Yeah. They said to the unknown.
That's right.
So that was Yahweh setting it up.
Right.
You already confessed you don't know anything about this.
Right.
So Paul said, that one is the one I declare
to you. That's right.
All right.
That's
the one I was just talking about. Because you've already confessed by your scripture.
You don't know a damn thing.
Right.
Him, I declare unto you.
That's right.
And by him preaching that unknown one to them, knocked all the rest of them
down. That's right.
It took them all out of their eyes.
That's right.
Out of their heart.
That's right.
But I'm saying that's why the apostle Saul wrote, you see, what he did, you see, to do it.
All right.
You understand? There is no other name given. Whereby the man. Now that was not to be taken as the schools are taking it now.
Right.
You see, that Joshua's going to save us. Joshua's going to carry us across.
No.
There's stupid things like he said he was the door. This ain't led to Yahweh nor Elohim. This said I am the door.
There ain't no door.
That's why I reneged on this. Anybody from Pasadena going anywhere suffering that phobia.
All right.
And that's out of love for you.
That's right.
That's right.
It's not against them.
No.
They've already declared themselves.
Yeah.
But it's because of love for you. I don't want you to suffer. I want
that's
you
right.
to understand. Mind be clear.
Yes.
Gospel being preached.
All right.
Written in your heart and mind and get you ready to go forth.
All right.
They've had their opportunity. And it becomes our indispensable duty to pass
all
it on.
Right.
If they should,
right.
as I'm saying, that's when it come all the way down.
That's right.
And just like Moses said, due to the line.
That's right.
No.
That's right.
All along God, we have, get over here.
That's right.
We're drawing the line now.
That's
yes,
right.
Yes, sir.
That's right.
Yes, sir.
That's right.
Yes, sir.
And sooner or later, you're going to bow to that that's in there.
That's right. That's right.
So all I'm talking about is anybody that has a true and living Yahweh Elohim that was manifested in Yahweh, Yahshua, in them, every man will have to bow to that.
That's right.
That's what I'm talking about. I'm not talking about Glenn W. Kennedy.
You.
That's
about
to
right.
I have to bow. You have to bow to Glenn W. Kennedy. No more so. And people have to bow to what they look at is
Yahshua. All right now.
That's right.
If you sure want to bow to that, it was in.
That's right.
That's what they bow to.
You see, the thing that people haven't caught on to yet, when Yahweh says, listen to me and help me. When Yahweh said, sacrifice and burn offering, thou wouldest not. Don't you know he said that in this state?
All right.
Don't you know when he created a man, he's done it in this state?
Yes, sir.
Right.
Yes, sir.
What are you talking about? I'm saying that was Yahweh, Elohim, and Yahshua right there.
That's go ahead.
That's right.
All right.
See, like my name is Glenn W. Kinley. Now, Glenn W. Kinley put on the suit of clothes.
Right.
Right. I can't
make
that no
plan. You got the suit of clothes, thought you had me.
Go ahead.
That's right.
That's how he led them into the
yes.
grave.
That's right.
Locked them in
that
place.
Right.
And when he was dissolved and appeared out, they were still locked up and ain't got out of it yet.
That's right.
So he's been loosed out. He still
does that body. Right.
He's still in.
That's right.
Now listen to those. I hope you listen. To those that are Yahweh, we recognize that the devil has always, tried to incarcerate.
Go ahead.
Elohim, I'll put it that way.
Right.
Just like we try to take wild birds.
Yeah.
And put them in captivity, they'll die on you.
That's right.
You follow?
That's right.
You understand?
They will.
I'm saying then, the gospel is preached with those that are risen from the dead to go be cast down to hell and preach the gospel to those, you understand?
Yes.
That's in hell.
That's right.
What are you talking about, man?
Right.
Some of those that have the spirit
yes.
of Yahweh in them
right.
and don't know it.
That's right.
It takes the genuine preaching of the gospel to free them out of that prison.
That's right.
You see?
That's right.
That Yahweh might be glorified.
That's right.
Not you.
No.
You understand?
Right.
And that's what you come into here. You see? This is a verse or two of it. That I've concluded.
Let us therefore fear,
Lest a promise being left us of entering unto his rest, any of you should seem to come short of it.
See?
Oh, boy.
Let them come short. They get right to here. You follow me? Joshua, now I ain't talking about flesh and blood. I'm talking about spirit and bone.
Come on.
They can fool with it. They don't know what they're doing. That means they haven't entered into this present yet.
That's right.
You see? You can read Romans 1:19-20 all you want to. They don't make no difference. If you set it in there correct, they argue with that.
That's right.
And you can't change it for the invisible things of him.
Hello.
That's right.
Yeah. That's right. Then they're going to still say, take the natural. To understand that, you know this common sense. You have that, or I smack you out at that tree you won't pass any friend up to you.
That's right. And you would.
You see what I mean?
Yes, sir.
Ain't nobody hear that damn dumb.
That's right.
It's of him. Yeah. That crazy tree to explain what he manifested in the tree.
Yeah.
You follow? I mean, forget who was telling Moses. Come up here.
Right. Come on.
And he was Moses and men.
Yes, sir.
Is it? Right. Read.
For unto us was the gospel preached.
But to us Hebrews was the gospel preached.
That's right.
Read.
As well as unto them.
As well as unto them.
All right.
But the word preached.
Back here.
Go ahead.
Read.
But the word preached did not profit them.
But the word preached didn't profit them. You understand?
Yes.
You claim that was Yahweh with us.
Yes. Go ahead.
And listen, from what they come, I ain't found out what Dr. Kinley is yet.
No.
Not from that conversation.
That's right.
They said Dr. Kinley was Yahweh himself, man, but they're waiting on Yahweh. Well, who was he?
Right.
Exactly.
And what did the gospel preach for him? What did it deliver you from? You understand? If it delivered you to wait on the Yahshua, then he was stupid for coming.
Yes,
that's right. Right.
Yahweh made a boo-boo in revealing himself to the man, Dr. Henry C. Kendall.
Right.
Oh, God.
Right.
Yeah. Peace, man.
He in that body, if you are thinking about it today, he in that body, let's come down. He kept his mouth shut here.
Right. Right.
You see? Because he had appointed a day,
that's yeah. Right.
Into which he was revealed, then put on a body in his last day.
Yeah.
Right where that day, right where he was cut off.
Go ahead.
He didn't say nothing. He appeared again on the scene in the clouds of this age.
All right.
And opened up his mouth and told us the secret.
That's
of
right.
Right.
Because that's what was
right.
In his heart.
That's right. Paul.
That's
good.
Right.
That's right.
To the extent you know Adam didn't write nothing about Satan couldn't do nothing with me.
Come on.
But he went to something that he loved.
Right.
You
yes.
Which was his wife. You follow me?
Jesus.
That man stood there and said, he knew he couldn't do nothing with me, so he went to Cain and my kids.
Come on.
Come on. Explain to us what happened that first day.
That's right. That's
and
right.
That was Yahweh with us.
That's
and
right.
Then Yahweh raises up himself.
That's right.
Yahweh. That's all he knows to create.
That's right.
By the pattern of himself.
That's right.
You see that? Right. Makes you one with.
That's
anything
right.
Short of that, I don't want it.
Yes, sir.
Right. That's true.
No that's with.
Read.
For unto us was the gospel preached as well as unto them.
See that?
But the
now
word
they've heard. Everyone in the mouth has heard.
Yes, sir.
You got people out there like, I'm saying my own cousin.
Go ahead.
But he told him he had the vision June 6th. Remember that? About 9 o'clock in the morning, 1930. And still gets up and preaches something different. Then another jackass says, well, it ain't important about the year. But the important thing is he had the vision. Hey, I'm saying this prophetic vision got to be on time.
That's right.
If it's not on time, then you and I are following after the doctrine of one that taught us is the erroneous doctrine.
All right.
That's how simple it is, man.
All right.
All right. You don't have no divine authenticity for nothing that you teach it.
That's right.
You know? And listen, I'm not talking about you worse than 18.
Come on.
The knowledge he has given you makes you one to
right.
Tell the same thing.
That's right.
You follow? But you, listen, you say, well, I'm the same as you, and practicing different things don't make you one with it.
Right.
Don't you know everything that pertains to eternal life as well as its temporal life has to coincide one with another?
Yes.
That's right.
You understand? It is these plates lining up yesterday. And correlated, you and I lining up.
All right.
In those places the world has to take
meat from.
Rise, eat, taste. You see what I mean?
All right.
You're going to have to eat what I'm giving you.
That's right.
You see what I mean? They're going to have to eat what you give.
That's all right.
If it's a job. And there's some folks like goats.
Yes.
They eat anything.
Yes.
And there was goats offered up back
then. That's right.
And all of them were scapegoats. They didn't escape nothing.
All right.
They're still bucking to this day. Read.
But the word preached did not profit them, not being mixed with faith in them that heard it.
See?
All right.
Not mixed with faith. See, when the gospel being preached mixed with faith.
Mm-hmm.
You see, it's just like you begin to make a cake or something, some ingredients. That goes to make up Elohim being quickened in you.
Yes.
You understand? Read.
But we which have believed do enter into rest, as he said.
See, we that believe have entered into rest. You tell me we ain't got there yet.
Uh-oh.
That's because as fast as you can read, or say something, I can read something contradictory.
That's right.
Now if you just be honest with me.
All right now.
You understand, if I was contending with someone, just be honest with me. John, Oliver, whoever. If you had a vision,
no.
Now be honest. No, this one did.
That's right.
And he said we've been in his rest.
Yeah. Right.
You say we have. See that now? What is entering into his rest anyhow?
Come on, Dad.
All the things of Yahweh. To you, you quit warring against
him.
You accept him. And everything is at rest with you.
That's right.
Because I am Yahweh. Well, I understand it.
That's right.
I'm not toiling with that anymore.
That's right.
See, I'm not wrestling against flesh and blood.
Right.
How could this be? And I don't remember being that you're warned. See, it's the gospel preached. You know what I'm saying? Say you Yahweh. Wasn't mixed with faith. Have faith with the one that told you.
Yes.
It's the truth. You see that now?
Oh, yeah, Dad.
And Yahweh does not war with himself.
That's right.
And you got that example in your own body. So when you lift the leg, you see, and you move an arm. You see, this part of the arm, I don't want to move that way. The muscle that way, I ain't need the strength to go. No, you think, no, friend, come back here. They don't go on.
Jeez,
man. Read.
As I have sworn in my wrath, if they shall enter into my rest. Although the works were finished from the foundation of the world.
The works were finished.
Yeah, it is.
That's what I tell you about the love of Yahweh. Just to draw it out.
Yes.
See, the works were finished right here. You see? It's just like, right? Well, I agree. It's like when it takes to produce a child. You see? Though it's love,
come on,
the relationship is a work.
That's right.
Right.
Now, when the child comes forth, right. It begins to, you understand, it starts to work for both.
That's right.
That's right.
That's a good example.
Oh, that's great.
See? And you bring forth a new creation.
That's great.
In rest.
Wow.
And it's taking place in the realm of eternity.
Right.
That's been why the mother nor the father know when.
Oh, Jesus.
Wow.
All right.
Wednesday and Friday from 7:30 to 10.